This is Teutonic Penguin, and today I will be doing a video on my 14th century armor kit. I've been putting this kit together for a bit over 4 years now. It consists of partially plate armor, splinted armor, and arming wear. Let's begin. I will be donning a splinted leg harness, starting with the greaves. Now I will put on the splinted cuisses. To suspend the cuisse, I have made a sash-like garment with leather tabs sewn on, leather cord looped through. You simply put the cord through the holes, pull it tight, and tie a half loop. Next I will put on the gambeson. This here is a 14th century style with cloth buttons running down the front. The padding is somewhat light compared to the earlier gambesons due to the fact that plate armor absorbed much of the shock. This gorget is actually a later period, however, the extended neck protection is necessary during reenactment combat. The next piece I will put on will be the cuirass. However, I will require assistance, so I will be back shortly. Alright, I am now fitted in the 14th century cuirass. This was originally a 15th century piece that somebody made, however I removed the hanging tassets, formed it to be a bit more tight fit, and made the stop rib and added it myself. Now I will put on the splinted arms, which I will also require assistance to put on. In the gambeson I have these arming points, similar to the way that I attached the leather to the sash, we have the leather cord running through, which will support the arm harness. Now with the arm harness attached to the arming point, I can continue on to buckle these straps. Like that they are properly attached. Next I will put on the arming cap. I also wear this padded gorget. Here my sword, the wooden cross. The sword I will wear around the breast plate. The scabbard includes a belt attached. This is a later century army sword, meant to be wielded one-handed, fairly light. Balance point rests, it's about there. Perhaps an inch too far, that's due to the wide blunted blade, which is made for reenactment, so it can withstand a lot of abuse. This one is made by Mayhawk Armory. I also have here a small dagger. It is not typical to the 14th century, but for now it is a temporary piece that I use in combat, in case I become disarmed, that I usually put on the back and slip it in like that. Finally, I have a small punch shield. True to its name, its best use is jamming the end into your opponent's helmet. They are rather light and provide ample protection despite their shape. This one I made myself. It is made from half-inch plywood, two layers of canvas glued on, and rawhide tacked on the edge. I have a strapping system on the back, including two buckles and a cross strap for the hand. For the hands, I have these hybrid gauntlets. They are a mix between mitten and finger gauntlets. They are not perfectly historical, but they were incredibly affordable and offer excellent protection in combat. I also wear these finger bucklers. They add a bit of extra protection for the fingers, just for peace of mind. Finally, I will put on my great helm. This is a Mathelm year 1400. It's made of 14 gauge steel, includes interior padding and a chin strap. With that, I'm fully armored. I also have here a 14th century German halberd. Most knights would use pole weapons in battle, and if the shaft were to break or they were to be disarmed, they would then resort to using their arming sword, paired with a shield. For 4 years now. This kit is completely made from 16 and 14 gauge steel, 14 gauge for knees, elbows, gauntlet plates and helm, and 16 gauge for the splints, shoulders and cuirass. If you have any questions, please let me know. As always, comment, subscribe, and thanks for watching.